Hello learners, welcome back. I'm Dr. Neetu Shukla and today I'll be discussing with you the higher forms of writing such as paragraph writing and essay writing. Now you know that we have discussed so far the various elements of writing, the accuracy, brevity and the clarity which one has to ensure when we are writing something. But as you go on and teach the higher classes, you have to discuss various forms of writing as well with the learners, such as paragraph writing, essay writing, letter writing, story writing, and poetry composition. These are some of the forms which we'll be discussing in the subsequent session. Now, if we talk about paragraph writing, you know what is a paragraph. Why do we write a paragraph? The objective of teaching paragraph writing is to build the skill of organization amongst the learners, that they should be able to organize their thoughts in a proper order. The learner should be able to gain awareness of the structure of a paragraph. Another objective of teaching how to write a paragraph is to develop the ability of stating the main idea clearly, providing them with sufficient supporting details as well. Now, if we talk about paragraph writing, what goes into paragraph writing? First and foremost, the child or the learner should be able to express the topic sentence appropriately. For this, the skill of collecting and presenting supporting details should also be provided. The learner should also be given numerous opportunities to appreciate the importance of writing a good paragraph for writing essays, etc. Just look at this particular paragraph and let us analyze it as to how it should be taught to the learners. Listening to music is my favorite activity. I tune into FM radio whenever I wish to hear old music songs. The songs provide me pleasure. It makes me stress-free and happy. It helps me in changing my mood. I can do so many things such as daily house chores while listening to music. It helps me to stay focused on my task as well. When I am sad and disturbed, it lifts my spirit as well. So, listening to music is my favorite leisure activity. Now, when you discuss such a paragraph with the learners, first thing that you should do with them is to help them identify what is the main idea of this paragraph. What is this paragraph talking about? It's definitely dealing with music. Now, which is the topic sentence in this paragraph? And then, followed by that, we have to ask them, then can you spot some of the supporting details in this paragraph which the writer has mentioned? Let us look at this paragraph once again. Listening to music is my favorite activity. This is definitely the topic sentence of the paragraph which goes on to tell us that what this paragraph is going to talk about. I tune into FM radio whenever I wish to hear old movie songs. So we know that the writer is saying that since listening to music is his favorite activity, he prefers to switch on to FM radio whenever he wants to listen to old music songs. Now these songs provide me pleasure. This is one of the supporting details as to why the writer enjoys listening to music. It provides him pleasure. Second detail, if you note, is that it makes me stress-free and happy. Another supporting detail is, it helps me in changing my mood. Followed by, I can do so many things, such as daily house chores while listening to music. So you see that the writer is supporting his topic sentence that listening is his favorite pastime or he enjoys listening by supporting with so many ideas as to what all he gains out of this particular experience. It helps me to stay focused on my task as well. So all these lines which you can see underlined are actually the supporting details of this particular paragraph. So when I am sad and disturbed, it lifts my spirit as well. I find listening to music as a great activity to spend my leisure time. So now this last line which you can see is in red color is actually the concluding line of this paragraph, which is once again stating the topic sentence in a different manner. So this paragraph is presenting one single idea. This is what a paragraph is supposed to do. That there has to be one single idea which has to be presented followed by supporting details. And the paragraph should have a topic sentence which goes on to tell the reader as to what it is going to be about. And it should conclude with a statement which reinstates the fact, which reinstates the main idea or the topic sentence of the paragraph. So when you are teaching your learners how to write a paragraph, you have to give them, you have to show them a number of samples. You will have to show them different types of paragraphs and analyze along with them that what are the key elements of paragraph writing which have been used by the writer in these cases. Now, there can be numerous activities which can help learners acquire the skill of writing a paragraph well, because as you know, paragraph forms the building block of any longer piece of work, whether it is an essay, a story, or autobiography, or biography, or a letter, whatever. Any kind of higher form of writing will definitely involve paragraph writing. So one of the activities which can be easily used by you in the classroom is the use of the tree structure. Now, in this tree structure, what happens that you give them a chart, you have the main idea at the top of it and which has to be followed by the subsequent supporting details which are occurring in that particular paragraph. So you give them a paragraph and followed that with a tree chart or a tree map, and the learners are supposed to read the paragraph, and while they are reading the paragraph, they have to fill up this tree chart. So if they are able to do that, they will definitely be able to focus on the various parts of a paragraph. Another idea can be the most popular, which you know recently nowadays being used, is that you tell the learner that look, when you are writing a paragraph, it follows the model of a burger. So you have the top, which is the main idea, followed by the layers, which are the supporting details of that particular main idea, and followed by a base, which is the concluding statement of that particular paragraph. So you can give visual clues as well to the learners so that they can use those pictures or visuals to organize their thoughts and write a paragraph on it. Another activity can be that you can give them two paragraphs which are jumbled up. So you have paragraph 1 and paragraph 2 and you fuse them in one way or the other and give them to the learners. The learners will be asked to separate the two paragraphs which have been interlinked. So they can be asked to separate the two hidden paragraphs from the combined form which has been given to them. Another activity can be you give them verbal cues. So you give them some main idea and along with that some cue words. So then the learners can be given some time to organize their thoughts and write simple paragraphs of 10-15 lines each. Another activity can be that you give learners paragraphs with mistakes and ask them to edit. So for instance, you can have a paragraph where you don't have any topic sentence. So the learners will be expected to read the paragraph and identify that look, the topic sentence is missing in this paragraph and it has to be provided so that it becomes a complete whole. Another activity can be that you ask them to identify the main idea or topic sentence or supporting details in the given paragraph, and it can be done with the use of the image of the traffic light, where you have the green color coding for the topic sentence, the middle one can be the orange color coding for the supporting details and followed by the red colored coding for the concluding line. Now another form of higher skills of which are used in writing is the essay writing. Now when I began this particular session, I told you that paragraphs are the building blocks of the higher forms of writing, and essay writing is one of the most respected and complicated form of writing. So when we look at the an essay, it is actually a combination of a number of paragraphs and each paragraph conveying one idea or the other. It consists of several paragraphs which are arranged in a logical manner. There may be several purposes of writing an essay. Some of the purposes could be that you want to narrate an experience, you want to describe something in detail, or you want to provide a detailed information in a more balanced manner. One of the objectives of writing a paragraph could be that you want to persuade the reader about your idea, about your perspective on certain things. So now, as teachers, you would be wondering that how should we teach essay writing to our learners? Again, there can be several things, but the key elements writing an essay includes, number one, how to create an outline of the essay. What is it that you want to talk about? For instance, if you want to talk about the environment, the concerns of the environmentalists as to how the children are being oriented towards the saving of their natural environment, saving of natural resources. So once you give this topic to the learner, then ask them to write down or brainstorm their mind as to what all ideas can be included while talking about that thing. Next, you have to identify your thesis statement. What do you want to convey? What do you want to support? What do you want to emphasize in this particular essay? This will be followed by an introduction. You prepare the introduction, whether you want to begin with a quotation, whether you want to begin with some anecdote or some experience sharing. So you decide upon the kind of beginning that you want to give to this essay. Next, you should know how to build up the main body of your essay. What all will go into it, what all paragraphs will be included, and how each paragraph will build one point and the other. Finally, the essay has to be concluded with a proper conclusion. Now, when we are assessing the learner's performance on essay writing, then several things can be kept in mind. First and foremost is the creativity, the creative use of language. Another thing can be the expressions which have been used, the words, the sentence structure. And yes, of course, how the expression which is used in that particular essay is accurate and how fluent the ideas are. How each paragraph is connected to the next paragraph and the cohesion is there in that piece of work. So we talked about fluency of thought that should be there in the essay. Comprehensiveness of the topic as well. That the topic which has been given, it should be well covered in that particular essay. Clarity of expression and other such parameters should also be kept in mind. Now here I must mention that when we are talking about essay writing or whenever we are talking about the skill of writing, then we have to nurture amongst our learners the habit of working on their drafts. So when they draft the first attempt to write out something, then ask them to revisit it and edit it once again. That editing can be in terms of the vocabulary which they have used, the spellings which they have used, the ideas may be further enhanced, more supporting details may be provided. So inculcate in them the habit of first preparing the first draft and then moving on to it by going back to that particular draft again and further enhancing the quality of that piece of work. So when this activity is done with the learners, that they are asked to maintain their first draft, work on it once again and come up with another draft, the skill of writing gets enhanced. They become more conscious of the vocabulary that they are using, how they are using, how well they are able to bring about cohesion and clarity in their expressions. Now, letter writing is yet another very crucial form of writing which is usually practiced in the higher classes. Now, what is the purpose of letter writing? All of us know that yes, when we are writing a paragraph, it has a specific message to convey to people who are living at a distance. So, what could be the subjects of letter writing? Maybe you want to write a letter to congratulate a friend on the latest achievement which they have had. Maybe you want to thank somebody or you want to seek information. Maybe you want to write a letter to the editorial or you want to place an order to a particular publishing house. You may write letters to the editor, you may write letters to relatives, friends and so on. So there can be numerous subjects on which you are writing a letter. So when we look at the subjects of letter writing, then we can easily classify them as formal letters and we can classify them as informal letters. The formal letters are the ones which follow a definite structure and they are usually given to people who are at a higher position in a particular organization. The language which is used in these formal letters, it is more formal. Whereas informal letters are usually the ones which are written to your friends, to your relatives, and where you may not restrict yourself to the formal usage of language. So when we look at the format of a letter, because this is the first thing which you have to convey to your learners, that when we have to write a letter, there is a particular format which has to be followed. So at the top, we should have the sender's address at the top right hand side. Next, it has to be followed by the address of the receiver of the letter. On the left hand side below the sender's address, the date has to be mentioned. The subject has to be mentioned if it is a formal letter. The salutation, whether you want to write dear sir or madam or missus. This has to be followed by the message, very crisp, clearly stated. Followed by a complimentary clause where you write yours faithfully, yours sincerely, etc. And then the letter ends with a signature followed by a full name. Now, the full name has to be mentioned clearly so that the person who is receiving the letter knows that who has written the letter, because many a time the name may not be very clear and visible in the signature. Now, some of the activities which can be used by you as a teacher for teaching letter writing, making the learners more conscious of the use of the format, the correct format and the language for letter writing, could be that number one, you can have a post office corner in your classroom. So you create a letter box in your classroom, and your learners, they can, you know, every day or maybe once in a while, they can write a letter and post it in that particular letter box. And in your English class, you can once in a while open up that particular thing, and it can be exchanged to the particular, to the desired person, it can be posted. So they can write letters to their friends, they can write letters to their parents, they can write letters to their teachers. So numerous possibilities are there. Another activity can be that you ask them to sort given letters as formal or informal. You give them samples of maybe 4 to 5 types of letters and ask them to sort or categorize or put them in the pockets. This is the formal letter pocket and this is the informal letter pocket. So they have to categorize the letters into these two pockets. Another thing can be that you provide them with letters where there are details which are missing. Maybe the subject is not there, maybe the introductory part of the letter is not there, or the concluding line is not there, and you ask the learners to provide the missing details and complete the letter. Finally, a very interesting activity which learners usually enjoy is that of editing given letters. So you give them letters and then you ask them to edit it. And editing, at the time of editing, you give them the guidelines that, okay, these are the things which you have to keep in mind while you are editing. So you look at the format, the way the date has been written, the kind of salutation which has been presented, the kind of complimentary clause, the language which has been used, the spellings, the words, everything. So you give them certain pointers which they have to keep in mind while they are editing those letters. So by doing such things, you can draw the focus and concentration of the learners on these aspects of letter writing. Story writing is another interesting activity, another interesting form of writing. This is usually used for stimulating imagination and creative expression amongst the learners. It is also believed to spread and nurture the love for literature amongst the learners. There are numerous activities which can be used for stimulating this interest in writing of short stories. You can ask them to give appropriate ending to stories. So you give them one paragraph of a story, the beginning of a story, and you ask them to write the ending of that particular story. Or you can give them certain hints. Now those hints can be in the form of words, that you give them some words and you give them some visuals, or you can give them some other ideas and ask them to develop the stories based on those hints given. Yet another interesting task which learners usually enjoy is the rewriting of fairy tales. So you can ask them to rewrite the favorite fairy tale which they remember of their childhood. So it could be Cinderella, or it could be the Three Bears, Goldilocks and the Three Bears, anything. So ask them to rewrite that story and you will find how imaginative they become in the use of language and how their creativity will pour in while they are writing their thoughts and ideas in composing that particular story. Another task could be that you ask them to rewrite stories from the point of view of any character. So give them some story to read, and once the story they have finished reading it, then you ask them to pick up any one character from that particular story who really appealed to them, and from that character's perspective and view, ask them to rewrite that story. Poetry writing. This higher form of writing engages the learners in developing their aesthetic appreciation for the creative use of language, how language can be used for expressing a person's emotions. It helps the learners to appreciate the emotions expressed in the poem. So when we talk about Wordsworth, then there are so many poems such as Daffodil comes to our mind, how the flowers evoked such a myriad of feelings in the poet's mind. The learners can be asked to comment on the poetic style of the poem or analyze the tone of the poem, the words which have been used in the poem, the expressions which have been used, the poetic devices which have been used in the poem. And above all, let them enjoy the poem, let them recite the poem, let them listen to the poem and appreciate it. Some other suggested activities for teaching of poems is that parallel reading of a poem on a similar theme can be given. So suppose if they are reading a poem which is, say, snake, then they may be given a parallel reading of a poem which is on a mosquito or maybe some other insect. Let them see how the two poets, they express their emotions in different ways while they are talking about a different living being. They can be asked to rewrite a poem in their own way. So when they read a poem on a snake, then they can be asked that, okay, now that once you know that, okay, this is how this particular poet felt about the snake and this is how he has composed his poem. Now suppose you encounter such a creature in your home, and if you were to compose a poem on that, how would you do that? Ask them to engage in this poetic use of language. Further, they can be asked to comment on the poetic style of the poet. Again, very interesting is, just we talked about that how they can revisit the short stories of their nursery times of their young age, they can revisit the nursery rhymes as well. Ask them to rewrite any nursery rhyme which really appealed them and which really interested them in their primary years. Oral recital of a poem in class is also a very interesting activity. With this, we come to the end of this session. We'll meet again. Thank you.